guys, how are you today? Alrighty. We are going to work on prepping our May inserts, or our May pages for our My Year 2017 journal. Now, our prompt for the month is Think Spring / Tip It In. So today we're going to have that prompt in mind, and we are going to decorate our May insert here. And I'm going to show you how to do a tip-in. We're going to talk about tip-ins. I do want to tell you, as I'm filming this, there's still one more week to go in April. one more week to go. Maybe not quite a week, a few days. We're not quite done yet. But this is my April inserts. How far we've gotten with it. I think it turned out really great. It's very interesting. Lots of funness and texture, right? So the first thing we're going to talk about is tip-ins. So, you know, every month I do a tip-in. I add my book list, something to put my book review list on in my section of my journal. Tip-in, the definition on Wikipedia of a tip-in is the act of gluing in or taping in a page to a bound book. So the idea behind this tip-in is you're adding an extra page into your book, either from the edge or from the spine. So we're going to do that again, actually, and I have hopefully an interesting way of doing it. This is my book list doodle that I'm going to use this month. This is a free doodle that I created for you all. It is part of a group of freebies that you can find in the files section of our group here on My Year 2017. If you're watching this on YouTube and you're like, what group? What is she talking about? And you're not a part of the group, well, why not? Go join. It's over on Facebook. It's free. It doesn't cost anything. So the link is in the description. So go join. Okay, now I got this from Ulta not long ago, and they send you basically the gift card with the idea that you're going to take it in for Mother's Day and go put money on it. I don't need anything from Ulta, so I didn't even show my daughter that this came. I'm going to unglue this carefully, hopefully. I like the colors of it. Oh, see, I ripped it. That's all right. I want to get the card out. So let's take the card out. There we go. So that can be used for gluing. So save that kind of thing. I love old gift cards and stuff for use for smoothing out projects and gluing things down. Okay, we're going to glue this back together and glue it back down. Let me get the lumpy, bumpy bits of glue down out. Let's see. I need my tape runner. There it is. So we've got it all sort of put back together. There we go. So I'm going to stick it down, and then I'm going to just do this, and I'm going to get that extra bit of tape runner off. Something is falling behind me. Did you all hear that? Okay. So that's cute, and I do want to use this as a tip-in. Obviously, it's too fat, right? So we're going to have to trim it. So I'm going to line it up here, and I'm going to just eyeball it. Yep, that'll work. So you always have the choice of tipping it in from here and adding an extra page here, or tipping it in from the edge. Now, generally speaking, I don't know why, but I usually tip in from the outer edge. If you are adding a piece on the outer edge, you want to leave about an eighth of an inch space between the piece you're adding and the existing page. If you're adding it in via washi tape, most of your washi tape's not that sticky. So you're going to want to put glue underneath and over your washi tape. I don't know if you saw last month, if it was even honestly on video, but I did add glue. I might have done it after the camera shut off, but I did add glue under this washi tape because this is one of the washi tapes that doesn't stick very well. And plus this paper that I tipped in is very glossy, so it didn't stick in very well. So you could just glue it in with a strip of paper. You could use masking tape. You could use any kind of tape. But if the tape that you're using is not that sticky, add glue. All right, I think for May, I might want to add it into the center. I think that would be interesting if we did. This is masking tape. This is patterned masking tape. This stuff is sticky. This is by Scotch. You don't have to add glue generally. Sometimes I just go ahead and add the masking tape, and then if it is an issue at some point, then I come back and add some glue. I'm going to take the insert, and I am going to run the tape up that folded edge so it's about halfway. Tape is about halfway on the insert and halfway up off, or a little, or it doesn't have to be exact. Okay. Then I just trimmed the two edges so that they wouldn't interfere and hang over the edge. And then I'm going to set this back just like if I was putting it at the outside edge. I'm putting it at the inside edge, but I'm still going to go about a quarter of an inch and an eighth of an inch away from the center seam, and I'm going to push it down to this page. I'm not actually pushing it down to that center seam. You see that? It's just stuck to the page. I'm going to grab another piece of tape as soon as I find the edge. There we go. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to pull this back. I'm going to push the tape down with my finger and stick it to not only this page, but to the other side of that tape that's on the other side. Okay. Then I'm going to come in and cut these weird, crazy edges off so they're more even. Okay. And just burnish it down with your fingers or a bone folder or something like that, and make it sure it's stuck really well. And then you've just added two more pages to your journal that you have to work with. Now, I do want to add my book club list to one of them. We have this hole here, which we're going to have to fill up. And I have to figure out what I want to fill it up with. I do think I know what I want to fill it up with. I have another one of those grocery list envelopes. Do I want to just stick that in there? I don't think I do. I think I want to put something else there. First, let's put our book list down. I'm going to just use tape runner. You could use glue stick. You could use Elmer's glue. Whatever you've been using. There's not really any wrong way. I am going to kind of do all the pages tilted up so that I don't stick all the different pages together, because that would be bad. All right, and then I think what I want to do is take a journaling card, and I think I'm going to just grab one at random. I kind of like this one. People are going to judge you anyway, so you might as well do what you like. When I found this quote on Instagram, something inside my head clicked. It's a very liberating thought. Jocelyn DeQuant. a Dutch journalist. I really like that, and that is very appropriate for me at the moment. So we're going to add that in. And it's just so that this side of the bookless paper is strengthened. We're going to give it some extra strength here. There we go. I love the way that looks. As we go along in the month, I'm sure I'll find something to stick there. I'm not super worried about it. I have all these different bits and pieces. I think I want to stop, though, and I think I want to... I made that really puffy. I have some of my inspiration stickers. These are my own artwork that has been printed onto a sticker sheet. This is one of the digital downloads you can get in my Etsy shop. And I think I'm going to use some of these in this month's spread. I'm going to just kind of space them out all in the month. This design, particular design, is also available as a rubber stamp. I have this whole thing of stickers that I've printed of my artwork and some that are from friends' artwork. I'm looking for ones that evokes the idea of spring to me. So, because we have, what is it? Think spring, tip it in, right? So we want bright colors, flowers, floral shapes. Here we go. And this is a misprint, so this is a good one to use. This one is one that misprinted. It only printed on part of it. It's a good one to use. We'll put it here and we'll fold it over. And we're going to take the other part of that. Let's use it too. Because this whole sheet is sticky. It's just that only part of it is die cut into the circle shape. But that's okay. Never stopped me before. There we go. Yes, I never throw anything away, if anybody's going to ask. I have so much trouble. This reminds me of spring. These bright colors on this paper towel. This is a paper towel. It's from one of my watercolor plays with the new neon palette. And when it was drying, I thought, wow, I really like the colors of that. So we're going to have to save that. And we are going to now collage it down. Now for this, we're going to probably need some matte medium. I'm separating the layers of the paper towel sort of gently. I did rip a big hole in it, but that's okay. I love some of the colors in here. So let's get some matte medium and let's tear off a few pieces. Isn't that a great piece? I'm going to tear it to fit the page so that I don't have to cut it. Yep. And let's get some matte medium in here. So I want you to think this week about how you can add extra pages to your journal, tip them in an interesting fashion, add fun bits and pieces in. I do it every month. Last month, I even tipped in the place card holders from the anniversary dinner that we went to celebrate my husband's 20th year at his job. I'll show you in just a minute. And that's a small tip in, but it could be considered a tip in. So I want you to just think about, that's not nearly enough matte medium. There we go. It's a super absorbent paper towel. So I want you to think about, you know, what you have as the month goes along, what's appropriate to your month, appropriate to your art journal, whatever you're working on that you could save and just tip it in an interesting fashion. It's especially fun to do when you have something that you want to add to your journal that has a pretty image on two sides. And instead of choosing a side, why don't you just tip it in and make it something that can flip out or can be turned so that you can see both sides. That's fun. So these are, where are they? So here, this was our place card holder on the table of the dinner that we went to. And this is the badge that they gave me to wear as a guest of Lamb Research and my husband. And so I took the magnetic part of the badge off and stapled this down. And then I took the place card holder and I cut the edges of it and taped it down. So it's this thing that flips out. I can put some journaling on here or some pictures or something like that. And I did one for mine and one for his too. So there's all different kinds of ways to tip things in. So I almost never add something to one part of my journal without adding it in at least one or two more places. So we're going to do that. The paper towel is no exception. I love this neon colored bright orange spot that's on here. I'm trying to get it fairly flat. The matte medium is nice to use because it dries pretty quickly. Okay, let's see. Do we have another little piece with some paint smear on it that we can use? Yes. I love this purple dot that's on here. All right. Let's add one more little piece. Maybe. Nope. Nothing back here, so let's put it back here. I'm not thinking about it too much. I'm just going with the flow, what feels right. Okay. So we're going to stick the paintbrush handle in there so it doesn't like all glue itself shut together. That would be bad. Very, very bad. I have some sticky embellishments here next to me. This particular set has flowers in it, so again, and butterflies and stuff. We're thinking about spring, right? So we're gonna put some of these in. Get those bits and pieces out that I know you all have hiding. The stickers, the tags. Get them out and use them. Just because it's an art journal or creative journal doesn't mean it has to all be full of painted images. I am just grabbing things that appeal to me. Oops. Now I have this star that says shine. May 18th is my wedding anniversary, so we are going to put that here. Ooh, this is a good one. Fall in love with your life. Okay, so have fun decorating your journal. Get out your stickers, get out your markers and your pens, add a tip in or two, and just have fun with it and play. That's it for right now. I will be back with more tomorrow or the next day. and I will see you soon. Have a great day. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you're watching this on YouTube. If you can and want to, join our Facebook group or support my channel by shopping in my Etsy shop. You can send me happy mail. You can send me an email. All the information on all of the different places to go do any of those things is in the video description, so check it out. And the most important thing is to have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.